We're paying our respect to Sister Kaboom Mahat for doing a tremendous, courageous job. And guess what? The force of Rastafari is here. I'm here with the legend, Ras Naibai, giving his support as always to a great crowd. What are your thoughts here today, Ras Naibai? I want to say this though, Ras Naibai, I know how you feel about His Imperial Majesty and also our Prophet, the Right Honorable Marcus Mosiah Garvey, but I want the world to hear it from your lips. What are you feeling? What Marcus Garvey means to you?
Well, God opened the door to the African consciousness, because prior to coronation, God was always speaking about the black thing. God was saying a black government, God was advocating the black awareness in our people. So there's no Rastafari, there's no Muslim, there's no African-centered people that were not touched by God. And that is global. If you talk about all the liberators of Africa, all the human rights, so, then you have to, everybody will say, Marcus was one of the pillars of consciousness that uplifted. So the Rastafari is the same thing. Awareness of African consciousness, and that is why up to today we hold God in high esteem. I mean, there is no orator of that era that has matched up with God, and the only other person we see we speak on behalf of blackness in that articulate manner globally.
Great words coming from Ras Naibai, but I want to ask him this. Ras Naibai, next week Sunday we come and we march 7 times. Ladies and gentlemen, we're talking about July 2nd, which is next week Sunday. We come again in Papin Square, but this time we're going to march 7 times around the wall of Jericho, the University of the West Indies. I know Ras Naibai is going to be here, but this is what I want to talk to him about. The 1st of August. Emancipation Day. I heard something powerful is going to happen within the movement of Rastafari. Does the Rastafari march on that day? Emancipation Day?
We'll be at the Scott Park Nyabingi Center for the Kwaskwis Centennial Celebration.
Repeat that again. The Kwaskwis.
The Kwaskwis. Come the 23rd of July. All Africa. African people of consciousness will celebrate the 125th anniversary of the birth of Haile Selassie I. That is called a Kwaskwe Centennial Celebration. So we'll be here at the Dingy from 23rd. Haile FM will be broadcasting live on the Sunday morning, so that Dingy will take us into the birthday, the marriage ceremony of Haile Selassie on the Empress on the 31st. Once there is an event planned for the first, then we will join forces with any movement of consciousness for emancipation. Because we recognize the importance of emancipation. The shackles being removed and we were free to go from one area to the next. We still have a lot of emancipation left. Because we still have emancipation of mind, and we still have an economic emancipation and all. That is very obvious.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, Russ Ivan, thank you very much for taking time out to talk to me. What do you want to say in parting? One last word of Malcolm X.
Black man must rise up. Now is the time. We were once a great people. We shall be great again.
Give that. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen, Russ Ivan, talking from the heart, speaking for Rastafari and the rest of the world and the rest of Jamaica. They try to give us a bus, ladies and gentlemen, that they say represent the essence and the life of the Honorable Marcus Garvey. We know better, and that is why we're here today, ladies and gentlemen, in the rain. Firestone Production and Big Stone is here in the rain for this cause. Because guess what? We're talking about the revolution. The revolution